Despite state demands, many parents say they still have doubts over whether returning to school is the right decision. Eric Levy going in depth to look at the virtual options for digital learning in the fall.
All right, Tom Jelneck, President and CEO of On Target Digital Marketing. Tom, it's been a while since we've seen each other. I know we've chatted on the phone and whatnot, but good to see you virtually.
It is great to see you, and thank you for having me today.
Yeah, definitely. So let's get to the business at hand. So what should be on people's minds regarding, protecting my information? What should I be thinking about?
So, you know, as more and more folks and kids are working from home, schooling from home, et cetera, what we're finding is a huge uptick in cybercrime. And, you know, think about it this way. Cyber crooks love to go after businesses, but right now there's a lot of people at home, and that's an easy target. So we really need to be thinking about security on our own machines, on our routers at home, and keeping all that software up to date so it's nice and safe.
Sometimes those passwords that you get when you sign up for your Wi-Fi service, whoever may be through, they're not exactly easy to remember, but sometimes that's good. I know when I got my Spectrum internet at home, it was a very uncommon password. Sometimes those are the better ones, right?
Yeah, some of those randomly generated passwords are exceptional. In fact, I just upgraded some of my hardware from Spectrum, and they gave me that printout that had this bizarre password on it. I'm like, how did you guys think of that one? But they're randomly generated, and I think that's really good. So certainly keep your passwords tight, right? And use one of those auto generators. Write them down if you're going to forget them, obviously.
Yes.
But, you know, the other problem that we're starting to see a lot more of is the Internet of Things, if you will. So there are so many devices connected to our home networks, right? And certainly we're adding more and more as, you know, my house, for example, there's four people with like 92 devices hitting the internet simultaneously. So, you know, these cyber crooks can find little loopholes in all of these devices and worm their way into your machine. So that's something we really do need to be aware of as well.
In May, the United Nations warned cybercrime was on the rise. Talk to me about this spike. And I mean, it's pretty astounding that the UN, it's gotten the attention of the UN.
Sure. So, you know, a lot of these bad guy crooks, these cyber thugs, are sitting at home waiting and preying on us because we're all working from home, right? Like, if you think about an office environment and you have an IT professional, they can really lock down the network and try to keep it safe. But they know that us at home can be lax, or some of our devices may not have passwords, and they're sitting there thinking and figuring out ways to weasel into our home networks.
What does the term cybercrime actually mean? I mean, we use it a lot, but what's the actual definition?
So it's typically, when it's referred to, it is typically the theft of or hijacking of someone else's either device or personal information. And we're seeing so much more of that, especially with ransomware. People are being held hostage. Their data is being held hostage for Bitcoin, et cetera. So we're seeing a lot more of that on the uptick.
And you get those emails still sometimes that have the quote unquote offers in them. But
yes.
It says click here, we'll take you there, or click here, we'll take care of this issue, whatever the issue is, ABC, XYZ. But, you click on that link and it's not going to take care of any problems. It's just going to add more.
It's going to cause way more. And sometimes what's happening is when you click that link, they're taking over your computer and then encrypting your data and selling it back to you, which is one of the most insidious things on the internet that can happen. The other thing we're seeing is, you know, a lot of fake COVID messages being sent to people. Click here to learn if your neighbor has it. And then, you know, it's off to the races with that as well.
Yeah, and I know one good thing that you've suggested in the past, and we can't talk about it enough, if you do get one of those emails, is kind of put your mouse or kind of move your, on the touchpad, move it over the link. Don't actually click it, but move it over, and you can see on that little box that shows up what the website is. If it looks fake, don't click it.
100%. If it's a really long URL, in fact, as I signed on to this particular software we're using today, I had all kinds of random chats that I hadn't seen in a while that were actually Google searches with insidious code wrapped into it. So today, more than ever, we have to be vigilant and really pay attention to what the heck we're clicking.
Tom Jelneck, president and CEO of On Target Digital Marketing, part of a family of four with 92 devices, each one connected at home. So keep those 368 devices at home safe. Thanks, Tom. Good to see you as always.
Great to see you. Thank you so much.